I'm going to start off with concealer, and I'm just applying a few dots under my eyes, and then I'm going to blend it out with a soft blender brush. This one's from Real Techniques. And you'll notice that in this video I actually talk a lot, and that's because I kind of made a mess up. I thought I was recording and you could hear me, and I made a lot of funny jokes and stuff, and unfortunately it didn't work, so now I'm doing this voiceover. So back to the tutorial, I am using my Face Atelier foundation, and I'm not doing a full face, I'm just doing kind of a spot treatment with the foundation, so I'm covering up red spots or any blemishes, and then I'm just going to soften it out with another foundation brush. Next, I'm going to set my foundation with a translucent powder. This is from Marcelle, and I'm just using a powder puff to really press it in so I get a nice smooth finish. Using a brush to dust away the excess. Alright, so next up is brows, and I'm using a matte eyeshadow from NYX and an angle liner brush from EcoTools. And like I typically do, I'm just starting on the bottom edge of my eyebrow, and then I'm gonna kind of blend it in as I go up. So for the majority of this look, I'm using the Geometric Elf palette. I think it's the 96 shade one. And I'm starting off with a very kind of smoky burgundy color. I'm applying it on the bottom lid and then sort of on the upper inner crease and then sort of blending it outward. And this is just kind of starting my eyeshadow shape. Just works as a nice little backdrop for the colors that are going to go on top. So the next color I'm going for is sort of this raspberry shade, and it is a matte, so I noticed it was a tad dusty, so I was really careful to sort of pat in the color and then blend it so that I didn't get any major fallout on my cheeks. So I'm just taking that color and blending it into the burgundy, or the kind of rich maroon shade, but I'm not covering my whole lid with it because I'm going to be applying another color on top afterwards, and I don't want the raspberry color to kind of muddy it up. So I'm just kind of blending that out, and I'm going to go back between eyes just to make sure the shape is roughly the same. Then I'm going to take this really nice rich orange shade, and I'm going right over top of those two blended colors. And I'm not going really very high up with this orange color, I'm just kind of using it as an accent. And again, I'm just mapping out kind of the rough shape. Then I'm going to soften this whole kind of lid area underneath my brows with a pressed powder. This is from e.l.f. and it's not really my favorite because it's really dusty, as you'll see as I blend. There's like this powder cloud billowing out, but it just is going to create sort of a soft backdrop. And more cloud smoke. Alright, so next I'm using a TKB glitter. It is definitely eye safe. I think it's called copper glitter. I'm not totally sure, but it's very, very shimmery and sparkly and beautiful. And I'm just applying it with a little bit of water. So I've dampened my eyelid with some water and then just packed that on. And then for my inner kind of tear duct area, I'm using a gold glitter, and it's kind of more of like a reflex, so it's slightly, it looks white, but it actually is a nice light gold. And I mean, you could use the same copper, I just wanted to change it up. And then I'm going to go in with a really black Kohl eyeliner, and I'm going to line my waterline and a tight line, and I'm going to go into the kind of inner tear duct area just to create a really defined shape around the eye. So after I've tight lined, I'm going to bring the liner just on the upper edge of the lashes. I'm going to blend this out a little bit with a brush, but just kind of giving it a stronger rim around the eyes. And then I'm going to curl my lashes and make my eye look really creepy when I do it. And then I'm going to apply mascara. And because the bottom area is quite a dark color, I like to apply two really strong coats of mascara on the bottom lashes, especially because I'm going to be putting false lashes on the top. I'd like to balance it out. And onto the upper lashes. So then I'm applying my favorite lashes currently, which are the Kiss number 3 lashes, and they are kind of dramatic, but they're not too crazy, I don't find. But I like to put mascara on them to make them really pop. And what I'm doing right here is I'm just kind of squishing the mascara tip into the base of the lashes, and this just makes them look thicker, and it also fills in any empty gaps that you might have left between the liner and the lash band. So after the eyes, I'm going to do a little bit of contouring, nothing major. And, you know, add a little bit more color back into my cheeks with a light pink blush. And then I'm going to throw on some lip balm because my lips are a little bit chapped, as you may have noticed. And I'm going to show you two lips. The first one is kind of just a simple nude lip. Nude lips are not my thing. You can tell by my face, I'm kind of like, meh. I tend to kind of go for colored lips. I just think nude doesn't look that good on me. So I'm going for this Jordana lip liner. It's very, very, very pretty. More natural, definitely, but it does bring out that burgundy combination in the eyes, which I think actually works really well. It doesn't compete. So that's a bonus. So that's the final look. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And until next time, stay beautiful. Want more beauty in your life or makeup business? Head on over to beautynewbie.com for your beauty fix.